fighter, a survivor, a brave-hearted leader, a warrior. We call her Mother, the provider, the protector. She strives to be the human directory, the physical guide of what God knocks out for our lives. From staying up for many late nights with cries and prayers and questions of why to, waking up to the sunrise, consciously aware that God is by her side, she survives. No matter how strong cancer tried to wear and tear her renew, she remained yoked and in tune with the Lord. And no matter how weak she would get from the physics of hospital visits from doctors to surgeons to nurses, you never find her running from the needles that picked her veins. In the pain that intentionally tempted her to go insane, you'd hardly find her complaining, because she had the dignity and understanding. She had the tenacity, the drive, to set an example of the means of making a sacrifice like Christ. And as the time was moving swiftly, her journey was defined by the saying, life on earth is temporary, however she survives. And when it comes to love, it is unconditional. Because with the dosage of pills throughout each day, her body would become emotionally frustrated. But with the unbalanced hormone levels built by grace, she still found a way to engrave a smile upon her face. Not even a malignant war of cysts that disintegrated her left breast could reach the core of her heart. Not even the stitches sewn upon her chest could weave those self-esteem within the spirit of her heart. And no matter how many times those respiratory machines tried to breathe life, no matter how much the chemo created sorrow, she made it her goal to believe that God had everything under control. What kept her physically alive was the Spirit of God that resided inside, giving her a desire to seek His grace, to lift her heavy eyelids, opening the gates of light to the shine from inside, to lift up holy hands almost every day to give God praise for His guidance to restore, for touching her heart, which felt the rhythmic feet consistently pumping energy, pleading for the touch of the blood of Jesus to feed her fragile body with more and more of His sovereignty. And today, I believe that somehow, someway, God implanted the spirit of her within me. Within her resided abundant beauty. In the dint of her cheeks unfolds a wide smile, revealing a peak of the wisdom she speaks, a harmony of life. Whenever she was knocked off her feet, her determination helped me to believe that something greater kept her alive. And as her youngest breathed, her battle always reminds me that you only get one chance to shine. And from the lessons learned, she taught me to have faith in Jesus Christ. Therefore, since I believe in resurrection, within me, she survive.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.